Hello, welcome back to another session of Adobe Experience Manager in Action with me, Veena Vikraman. So I hope all of you are staying safe, healthy. Those who have not got vaccinated, get your vaccine soon. Hope we can go out as soon as possible. What is that I'm going to cover on today's test session? Right. Let's say you are a new developer who is new to AEM, new to an AEM project. You are assigned an AEM project and you join the team, and the very first task was given to you where you are assigned a ticket, and in the ticket you are supposed to figure out a component. And like the business told you that, you know, in this XYZ page, there is this XYZ section where I have a title, and but, you know, I want to change the color of the title, or I want the feature to change the color of the title. Now, on a worst case scenario, let's say you don't have anybody who knows AEM, who can help you, and you are pretty much on your own to figure out the component, to figure out the page, to figure out what your business needs, and to figure out how to do it, right? Actually, throughout this video, what I'll be trying to explain is how to debug a component on a high level, not like code, but like if you know a page and if you know what section of the page you are looking at or what component you are looking at, how to figure out where that component is exactly in your CRX and how that component is getting executed. That is what we will be looking at. Depending on your knowledge in AEM, it might be easy for you at this point of time or difficult, but I would say go through this video, understand how a component is resolved, then go back to your project or whatever project you're working and try to take one or two components and do the same steps so that you get used to it. I don't want to confuse you much. So to start with, let's take a page. Now I have this page. Let's say my business is telling me, see, I have this article page, and in the article page there is this section where I have the title and description coming. You know, I want to add, or I want to change the format of the date, or I want to add another section to it, whatever. Now the problem is you are new to the team. You don't know basically what is this component at this point of time, but that is what your job is to, right? To figure out what the component is and give what the business wants, right? So let's say you know what the page is. So you go to the page, you saw the section, right? You saw, okay, this is the section which business is talking about. Now what you have to see is you can click on it, edit it, author it, but you don't have an option to change the date or whatever. Then how are you going to deliver what business wants, right? So what you have to do is, first thing, we have to figure out what exactly this component is or where exactly this component is in AEM. So as a first step, what you can do is you can go to the sidebar of your page and you will see a content tree, and if you know the component's name, well and good. Otherwise, you can get list of all the components and just click randomly on every component, and then you will see, okay, this component is a list component, right? Now what you have to do, basically go to this path in your CRXD. Okay, copy this path, put it in your content repository. Okay, put it in your content repository. Now you get the parent page in the repository. Go to the page structure. Now, this is the tilde root is the basic structure of your page, and obviously your parses is responsive grid, so you click on that responsive grid component. Now you see 1, 2, 3, 4 nodes here. Now you go back to your page, you can see that there is a title, image, there is a layout container, and then there is another layout container, and inside that you have a list component. So basically you go back to your node, so your layout containers will be a responsive grid, right? So you have a second responsive grid, and inside that you have the list component. So you have the second responsive grid and you have the list component. Inside this you click that list component. AEM's repository is based on JCR, right? Java Content Repository. So as per Java Content Repository specifications, everything is a resource, and every resource is identified as a particular type depending upon its primary type. For example, this particular node or resource is of primary type NT unstructured, so that is an NT unstructured node or resource for us, right? And when you go to JCR content, you can see that is of primary type CQ page content. So that is a resource or a node which is of type CQ page content. Every resource or node is differentiated into different type according to their primary types. In repository, your component node, your content node will be stored as a resource, and then your Sling has to figure out like from where that resource has to be resolved, right? For example, when the author edits this component, like when the author add values to this component, authors this component, that values get stored in this node for that page. So all the values of that particular component get stored in this node for this page. Now Sling has to resolve this component. So for that, the first point what Sling looks for is the resource type. Resource type is basically the component where that component is in your CRX, and that component is what which holds the rendering script or the entire business logic. It might not make sense at this point, but you will get there slowly, right? Let's take this particular list component for example. So you have this list component, your business or your author has added some values onto this pages. Now when he submits this component, this is getting saved here, and since he added this component in test article page, it is getting added under test article page. Okay, if he adds a new component, right, let's say he adds another list component, right? Now he added another list component and he authors it again with something different. Okay, let's say he authors it with these values. See, now if you go back and check here, you get another node, right? So there are now two lists. Why there are two list components? Because under this, under one page, you have added two different list components with two different set of values. So each list component has its own set of values, but it is the same component but added twice because it has to render two different set of values. Does that make sense? Hopefully it makes sense. But now let's come to our real problem, right? We have to first figure out where this component exactly is, because we don't want to, what we are looking at right now to change is not something which can be handled via authoring, like I can do something via authoring, right? I have to change the backend logic or the business logic of this component. So for that I need to figure out from where this component is actually coming, right? So you have to go to your components node, See what is the resource type of this node. Yes, Sling, when it resolves your resource, the first thing which it looks for is the Sling resource type. The Sling resource type is the path of your component. If that is a component, it is the path of your component. Now copy that Sling resource type, go to your CRX DA, and everything is controlled by configuration. So when I say you first look at apps and then lives, it's all controlled by a configuration which is out of the box configuration, which you should not be changing, but in case if you want, you can change. But I'm not mentioning about that configuration here right now because that's not really important. So as someone very new to AEM, just understand when you have a relative path like this, you first look it under apps, you put apps, apps, and then you paste that path. Make sure that is pasted correctly and then click enter, right? And you will find that component here. So I was already there, that's why it not navigated. So you find the list component here. Now the problem is, we are using WKND project, right? Weekend project. Now, weekend project or WKND project mostly uses core components. Okay, I will introduce all of you to an additional concept here. So now, when you come to this list component, the first thing what Sling looks for, assuming let's say we are all Sling and we are trying to resolve this component. Now, first thing what Sling looks for is a file, right? By name, if your component is list, it looks for something called list.html. On a very simple, there are different different levels on resolving a resource, but I don't want to go deep into that. Just keep it very simple. Let's say it is going to look for list.html. We are using HTML. We'll keep it short. We don't have any JSPs. We don't have any other script, ESPs or any other script. So we are looking for a same name.jsp. So when your component name is list, your Sling is looking for a file called list.html under this. But as you can see, there is no list.html under this. Now, how to Sling? Now, there is no list.html, right? Now, where do you go and resolve this resource? Or where is this business logic coming from, right? Or where is this rendering logic coming from? So, the next thing what your Sling looks for is something called Sling resource supertype. You can go and Google it and, you know, try to understand what Sling resource supertype is, but I will tell you on a very high level. When Sling comes to a resource, the first thing it looks for is in a very simple terms, it looks for a same name node HTML. Now here in our case, it will look for list.html. Now there is no list.html. Now where does it go and look for the rendering script, right? So the next best solution for that is to see if there is a parent resource or from someone where this component actually gets its resources. So for that, it looks on the components property, it looks for a property called Sling resource super type. So from the name itself, you can say that it's the super type of this particular resource. So for this list resource, there is a super resource, and that resource is referred using Sling resource super type. And this Sling resource supertype is actually referring to a component. Now, again, the same logic, put slash apps and then paste your component and click enter. Now you got the supertype. Now here again the same logic, right? It is going to look for something called list.html here. If it is not there, again we will look for a resource supertype. And if there is no resource supertype, then it's going to throw us an error. Okay, so let's see if there is a list.html. Yes, there is a list.html. So this is where our Sling is going to come. It will come here, it will start rendering this piece, right? List.html. Now obviously this list.html, I know from this line 16 it start executing, so it will actually import a list model And then from the list model, it will get the list items, and then that list item, it will iterate and print it. Okay, because this is a core component model, I don't have that handy right now. When you have to make any changes for this particular component, you have to get that model. So you have your code base, right? This is just an example. When it comes to your project and your component, it should be something in your code base, right? So your code base from the HTL, you figure out what model is that or where it needs some kind of change, and then you go to that model and then you modify that particular model, and then you build it and then you install it, right? So that is how your resource gets basically rendered, right? The entire logic, that's how you actually resolve your resource. In this entire video, what we have done basically so far is, like, assuming that you are a new developer to your team, business gave you a requirement where they gave you a path and showed you one section and told that, okay, I have this title description section, I need a capability to, you know, maybe add a new description to it, or, you know, change the text of the color or whatever, right? They just gave you some requirement. Now, as a fresh developer, you don't know what that component is, where that component is in the project structure. You don't know anything about that component. From the page and the section, how you can find the exact component in your code base is what this entire video was. So we started from the page, we went to the repository, we figured out the node, the content node of the component, and from the content node we figured out the resource type of the component, and from the resource type we went to the exact resource in our code base. We couldn't find it in that, we had to go to the super type and then figure out, right? So for this particular list component, that's how the entire flow was. Now I'll put another video where we will kind of without resource super type logic and with Sling model, I will try to explain you how you can actually make changes and then, you know, build it and install it and see those changes. So that will be for a part two of this video, but for part one, it will be till here. If there is something which doesn't make sense, please feel free to put a comment and let me know. I'll try to answer your questions as much as possible. If you have any suggestions, do let me know. I'll try to improve that, and I'll try to put more helpful videos in the future as and when I have some time. Thank you.